Hello students, today we will continue with the chapter irrigation and we will begin with the modern methods. Of irrigation. So the modern method of irrigation is an improvement over the primitive methods. That is clearly understood that these are an improvement. Over the primitive methods of irrigation. For example, tube well is an improvement of an ordinary well. Okay. Similarly, a perennial canal is an improvement. Okay, is better than an inundation canal. So today we'll begin with the course that is your tube wells. So basically, when we talk about the tube well, a tube well is a very deep bore. The tube well is a very deep bore dug into the ground, okay, with the help of a drilling machine, and the water is pumped out with the help of electricity. So it's a very deep bore. One more time, it is dug into the ground. Dug into the ground with the help of a drilling machine, and the water is pumped out with the help of electricity. Or we could also say that a tube well is deeper well. It is a deeper well, generally over 50 meters. About 15 meters deep, from which water is lifted with the help of a pumping machine, okay, or a pumping set operated by an electrical motor, or we could also drill the water out with the help of a diesel engine. So in case of tube wells, you clearly see that the role of electricity is very, very important in case of your tube wells. So moving forward, okay, we will mostly find tube wells. Okay, the construction of tube wells cannot be done everywhere. So the following situations, the situations that are important for the construction of tube wells, are as follows. Now, why are we learning about these? The situation is basically because tube wells cannot be constructed everywhere. It requires particular situations. Situations for the construction. So the following situations are necessary. Okay, the following situations are important for the construction of your tube wells. So firstly, when we talk about the first situation, groundwater supply should be sufficient. Groundwater supply should be sufficient. Because a tube well generally irrigates 2 hectares per day, okay, against only 0.2 hectares per day irrigated by an ordinary well. So for that to happen, the groundwater supply should be sufficient. In case of your next situation, when we talk about the next situation of tube wells, the water level should be nearly 15 meters. Okay, so that means the water table should be high. Okay. The water table should be about, okay, it should be nearly 15 meters. If the water table is more than 15 meters deep, okay, the cost of pumping out the water from the tube wells becomes uneconomic. So one more time. The second situation would be that the water level should be nearly 15 meters. Okay, it should be nearly 15 meters. If the water table is below or if the water table is more than 50 meters deep, then what happens? The cost of pumping out the water from the tube well becomes uneconomic, or we can say it becomes very, very costly. Number three, when we talk about the third situation in case of the construction of tube wells, regular supply of cheap electricity or diesel is essential for lifting the water in case of your tube wells. Fourthly, when we talk about the fourth situation, agricultural land should be fertile in the surrounding areas. Why? Which can compensate the cost of using the tube wells with the production. Okay? Because if the farm production is good, what will happen? They will be able to compensate the cost involved in digging the tube wells. If the production is not good, farm production is not good, what happens? The cost becomes really high. It becomes difficult for the farmers to construct a tube well. So in case of this, the agricultural land in the surrounding area should be fertile. So these are your situations that are necessary for the construction of a tube well. Now moving forward, let us talk about the advantages or the merits of tube wells. So firstly, when we talk about the tube wells can irrigate larger areas. Okay, that is its first advantage of tube wells. Number two advantage is that in dry period, they do not dry up due to the deep boring, which can reach up to the permanent water level. So in dry periods, they do not dry up. Okay, as the water reaches up to the permanent water level due to the deep boring that takes place. Number three, when we talk about the third advantage, water is not polluted. Okay? In case of this, water is not polluted. Why is the water not polluted? It is because as the water is pumped up from the ground itself, so what happens? The water does not get polluted. Fourthly, when we talk about the fourth advantage, what happens is that they do not give strain to men and animals. As these tube wells are worked by electricity, so they do not give strain to men and animals. Basically, why? Because they are worked by electricity. As the water is pumped out with the help of electricity, it does not give strain to men and animals. When we talk about the fifth advantage of your tube wells, we'll say that several chemicals are mixed with the tube well water. Such chemicals add to the fertility of the soil. So, it adds to the fertility of the soil. How does it add to the fertility of the soil? Basically, because when the water is pumped out, it comes out with several minerals mixed with it, which adds to the fertility of the soil in an overall manner. So when we talk about one more time, the advantage, it can irrigate larger areas. We can see that it does not dry up during the dry periods. Water is not polluted. No strain is given to the men and animals as it is totally operated by electricity. And lastly, it also tends to add to the fertility of the soil. Now moving forward, let us talk about the the disadvantages of tube wells. So firstly, when we talk about the first disadvantage of tube wells, they are very costly to set up. They are very costly to set up. If they are costly to set up, what happens is that poor Indian farmers will not be able to afford it. So that becomes a negative impact. So thus your disadvantage. Number two, when we talk about the tube wells cannot be constructed in remote areas where cheap electricity supply is not available. So it cannot be constructed in areas where cheap electricity is not available. As you can clearly see here, that in case of tube wells, electricity tends to play a very important role. So if there isn't the availability of cheap electricity, the cost will go very high. Thus, that becomes a disadvantage in case of the tube wells. Number three, when we talk about the third disadvantage, tube well construction is possible in soft soil areas. But in peninsular India, the surface is hard. So tube wells are popular in northern India. So tube wells construction is mostly possible in your soft soil. Construction in soft soil. As the peninsular India have harder soil, so what happens, it means of hard structure. So what happens is construction in case of peninsular India is not possible. So soft soil is more popular in northern India. So it is more popular in northern India. Fourthly, when you talk about the fourth disadvantage in case of your tube wells is that it is not fit in areas of brackish water. Not fit for areas with brackish water. It needs to have good groundwater rather than the brackish water. Fifthly, when we talk about the fifth disadvantage, in the event of drought, what happens is that the ground water level falls artificially, or we could say it generally falls below the required level. Okay, required level falls below the required level of water, and the water is not available when it is needed the most. So in case of, we had it in the advantage as well, in case of disadvantage, we have that in the event of drought, the ground water level falls. Ground water level falls. Thus, what happens is that in case of drought, okay, the water level may not be available, thus adding up to the disadvantage in case of your tube wells. So one more time, when we talk about tube wells, they are costly to set up. They can be constructed in areas where cheap electricity is. They cannot be constructed in areas where cheap electricity is not available. Construction in soft soil, that is why more popular in northern India, cannot be or not fit for areas with brackish water. And lastly, when the ground water level falls, it does not become suitable. Okay, thus not being able to utilize the water. So in case of this also, we come to know that these are basically the disadvantages of your tube wells. Lastly, in case of tube wells, let us talk about the areas. Okay, well, talking about the areas under tube wells, we will see that Uttar Pradesh has the largest area under tube wells. Following this, the other major states includes your Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, etc. are your major areas in case of tube